Welcome to the third of four videos introducing the Weather Project. In this video, we will look at how to record and enter your data for the class dataset, things to consider when you look at the class map, and how to earn full credit on the discussion. So to revisit the project outline, this video will cover the data entry and class discussion component of the project. The class dataset is the foundation for the class discussion and a lot of your own write-up too. You're given two choices of dates to collect your data. You only need to collect data on one of these dates. Once you have figured out a setup for your thermometer, which was covered in the first video, you need to collect your data for the class dataset and enter it. Let's take a look at how to do this. Okay, let's say that I have recorded the temperature with my thermometer. I now need to find the latitude and longitude of my location. The easiest way to do this is to open up Google Maps and zoom in on your location. Then select the location tool here and click on your location. The decimal degrees for your location are listed right here. Make sure that you list a positive value for the latitude because we are in the northern hemisphere and a negative value for the longitude because we are in the western hemisphere. To enter your data, select the data entry sheet that correlates with your date on the project handout. Notice that I am using an old project in this video, so the dates will not match the one for this quarter. Next, let's take a look at some things to consider when you look at the class map. I generate the class map 1 to 2 days after the data entry is due. Here is one from a past quarter. Notice that you can turn on and off the time periods from the pull-down menu. Notice patterns from taking data at different times of day. Look at the data for outliers. Are there data points that don't make sense? Here is one that is a lot warmer than the others. Let's take a look and see what's going on. It looks like this may be an urban heat island in the student's backyard. Here is another one that is way off in the ocean. This is an example of error in data entry. Both of these cases are typical of real-world data sets. One of the objectives for this project is for you to recognize the difference between good and bad data. In other words, what do you consider and what do you ignore? The next thing that we will look at is what you need to do to complete the class discussion. To earn full credit, you need to make a minimum of 3 postings. Your first posting should include a description of the thermometer setup and a discussion of what you think affected the temperature in your area. For more on that, see the second video in this series. Finally, attach a picture of your thermometer and setup. For full credit, you need to also respond to 2 classmates and engage them in discussion. Okay, that's it for this video. The final video will cover your 5 days of data collection and what to consider in your write-up, as well as what you need to turn in. Happy trails!